At the core of all social sciences lies understanding human behavior. Unfortunately, human behavior is, however, incredibly hard to study, as it is probabilistic, inhomogeneous, complex, and hidden. So, what are the tools we could use for studying human behavior? Well, statistics is great for studying probabilistic and inhomogeneous behavior, but unfortunately, it cannot cope with complex and hidden behavior. And simulations allow us to study the complexity of human nature, despite not being quite as rigorous as statistics. Probably the most critical aspect is, however, the hidden nature of human behavior, which so far no technology can address. What I mean by hidden is that our behavior is governed by mechanisms inside our head. These mechanisms might, for example, involve the interplay of personality, goals, and feelings. Unfortunately, there just is no way for us to directly measure these inner mechanisms. That is, without performing evil experiments on living brains. This is a big problem, because statistics is only able to study the relationships between directly observed variables, and simulations don't really allow us to learn from data in the first place. So, is it hopeless? Should we just give up trying to understand people's inner workings? Well, we humans are somehow able to get an idea about how people tick inside. Our approximate model of people's inner workings is what allows us to predict how people might behave and allows us to say things like, "I saw this coming." So, how do we do it? How are we able to create this model of the human mind despite not being able to actually see what is going on inside people's heads? Well, for one, we are constantly checking if our model is good by making predictions with it and seeing if these predictions were correct. Additionally to verifying the model's correctness with our current experiences, we can also verify it using our past experiences. So, if we somewhere notice a discrepancy between the predicted behavior and the observed behavior, we can make a small change to our model and check if it now has become better at predicting our current and past experiences. So really, we solve the problem of not being able to look inside people's heads by having a complete model of all inner mechanisms, and by checking the correctness of this big model as a whole. Now, if we verify this big, universally applicable model on many different experiences, we gain increasingly strong confidence in its correctness despite its complexity. The online platform Tree of Knowledge was inspired, amongst other things, by this way of evaluating and improving a big, universally applicable model. The online platform tries to mimic the way we humans build an understanding of the world, by providing a cohesive framework for accumulating knowledge and inferring a generally valid and rigorously tested model from it. So, for example, Tree of Knowledge also has a behavioral model of humans. It evaluates this model with many different datasets, which is the equivalent to evaluating it with many different experiences. Both are observations from the real world. Really, the main differences between the online platform and our mental framework for understanding the world are that the platform is statistically rigorous, which means that all the insights gained by it have associated uncertainties and are a direct consequence of the data and clearly stated assumptions. And the online platform has no limits to its growth. The more users upload data and evaluate behavior rules, the better this shared model becomes. The model in the online platform will eventually be based on as much data as might correspond to many lifetimes worth of experience. In comparison, the model in our heads is only based on our own experiences. This new, powerful platform is only possible because of many innovations. These innovations involve combining statistics, simulations, and various artificial intelligence technologies to a single cohesive framework. So, by copying the way we humans build an understanding of the world, we are now able to deal with all the difficulties involved in modeling humans in a mathematically rigorous and easy-to-use way. To find out more about this online platform, please check out the other videos.